while he was here, no pun intended, he arrived in 1935, and as he did in Paris in 1933, escaping from Germany, then he became what he felt was a French composer. When he arrived here, he wanted to be an American composer. And what I have done is, in a sense, to help him relive his songs through a greater expanded American idiom. In other words, Kurt Weill died in 1950. If he had lived and had experienced more, say, of the music of Duke Ellington, Billy Strayhorn, Gil Evans, Bob Brookmeyer, Thad Jones, what would his harmonization have been like maybe 30 years later? I think part of what I wrote for the German show incorporates that. In considering a vocalist for this show, my first choice was Caterina Valente. I've known Caterina for about 25 years. I did not know that she was the number one singer in Germany for pop type music, however you want to define that. Not music that is as expansive as the Kurt Weill material, and I knew from her musical background that she would be able to sing these songs and that she would love the challenge, because believe me, the Kurt Weill songs are challenging. They are not easy. Some of them have 2-octave ranges, and just the way he puts his intervals together, it takes a remarkable degree of musicianship to be able to bring some of the Kurt Weill songs to life. But for Caterina, no problem.
Good luck. Tchaikovsky? I love Russia. Russian composers. There's Malinchevsky, Rubinstein, Arensky, and Tchaikovsky, Sabelnikov, Dmitriev, Cherevnik, Verinovsky. Lodovsky, Kappen, Kutchev, Moni, Yutso, Akimenko, Zolomiev, Prokofiev, Tioki, Korichenko.
Thinking about Kurt Weill and the American songs, the Americans aren't the only people that don't know that Kurt Weill wrote these songs. The Germans don't know it either. The Germans are very well versed in the German material. Not just the Three Penny Opera, but Der Jazzager, the Berlin Requiem, Mahagoni, which is extremely famous, and it goes on and on. There's really quite a bit of material. There's a couple of symphonies, there's a sonata for cello and piano, and a considerable amount of vocal literature.
The American violin, the German violin, are two different persons for me. That's how I react to his music. He's different, and I understand why, because I must tell you something. When I work in Europe, I have a way to work. When I work in the States, I'm different. I have a different feeling. My interpretation is different. And Weill was exactly like that. He wrote his German things with Brecht, were fantastic. But when he came over, Weill was different. Was still Weill, but different. Yeah. Open, free, smiling. His music is a happy music.
There's a far land I'm told, where I'll And I was kind of scared the first night, because it's a straight concert. I don't do anything. I just sing and try to interpret the lyrics as good as I can. But then I found that they really enjoyed it, because I think they respect the band that is behind me. And they say if she sings like that, it's because she's part of the orchestra and part of the arrangement. She's not trying to be the middle, I mean, the special guest star. She's just part of the orchestra. They accepted that. And I'm very, very proud of her.
They received her beautifully. It was absolutely fantastic. Standing ovations, people yelling and screaming. So what we're talking about is a show that not only commemorates the beautiful, heartfelt genius of a songwriter and composer who wrote acoustic music, but we are now going to dramatize these songs and bring them to life with an acoustic big band, which I couldn't have been happier. And the WDR Big Band is as fine a band as any band I've ever heard.
When I play the song to my children, who don't know Weill at all, except his German songs like the Three Penny Opera and so on, they open their eyes. Say, is that called Weill? I said, yes. It's unbelievable. He's so soft. He's so human. He's so melodic. Because they used to the strong thing he used to write. But that was Brecht, of course. That forced him to write that kind of music. But when they heard Weill, the beautiful melody writer Weill, they just went, look at it, it's beautiful.
One of the things that one realizes in looking at the career of Kurt Weill is that he seems to be drawn to messages that are social commentaries, the shows that, you know, that he decides to do, like Lost in the Stars, like Joni Johnson. And part of that comes from what he called his operatic credo, which I'm going to read to you, just one key to him. He says, what moves us in theater is what grips us in all art. Heightened experience, the clarified expression of a feeling, humanity. And humanity is the real key here, because he is getting himself involved in projects that have a deep human message. And that is one of the things that I love about his music, because his music carries the depth of humanity.
Lost in the Stars moves me. The lyric moves me. And what a phrase that we're lost out here in the stars. It's the phrase alone will knock your hat off. It's kind of a shocker. There is a real sense of abandonment. That song's a masterpiece. And I was always fascinated by the stylistic change that occurred when he left Germany and came here. He was writing an extremely sardonic, dry, harsh music in the 20s in Germany, almost as an act of social criticism of the era they were living through. And the Three Penny Opera, I was familiar with its roots in England originally. And again, both periods were periods of intense political decay.
There is, I think, always this tendency of all of us to see, anybody who thinks, to see the worst in society. But Weill was writing in a period where all the signs were dark. You had the rise, you had Stalin in Russia, you had the Nazis here, you had this terrible depression in the United States, and you had the rise of Japanese militarism. totalitarianism of all kind gradually taking over the world. It's difficult at this point in history to realize how radically things have changed in only, as we sit talking, it's the space of the last 10 months. The collapse of these dictatorships in East Germany and in Russia and in Romania, it's an astonishing phenomenon that I never thought any of us would live to see.
None of us thought that.
I thought that was tyranny for a thousand years.
That's why, very early in the design of this show, I wanted to put Johnny's song as the encore.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't even listed in the program, because mm-hmm. that song really has to do with humanity and the hope of humanity, which was something that that concerned Kurt Weill.
And I'm so happy that you chose that song. Johnny's song is absolutely what I would like to say all over the world,
yeah.
in any country of the world. It's important. And Weill knew. And he knows because he's listening, I know. First created, I'm sure his maker meant he'd be of good intent, kind heart and love, forgiving wrong. Joy shall be our song. I meet all kind of folks who listen to my song. That's what life is about.